When I got up, I thought I had died and gone to hell. They blew up the mountain. They buried us. They buried themselves.
Oh God, Mateo.
I had to find him. So I went down into that hell. It was my only choice. I had to find Mateo. He could have been anywhere. Started with the first thing that came through the fog. There were allies pinned inside lodges. I needed to save them. Them before we saw them. Armored vehicles coming from the enemy fort.
But you didn't have your equipment anymore.
There were crates of enemy weapons in the lodges that we scavenged and prepared ourselves with.
Oh!
We could hear them before we saw them. Armored vehicles coming from the enemy fort.
But you didn't have your equipment anymore.
There were crates of enemy weapons in the lodges that we scavenged and prepared ourselves with. Sheer force of will, we took out their firepower. The lodges were safe, and I had to move on.
You never said, was Mateo in those lodges?
No. The men said his unit had made it further up. Some of the things I saw, Tesoro. I had to convince myself I wasn't dead.
Like what?
Fire. some of the things I saw, Tesoro. I had to convince myself I wasn't dead.
Like what?
Fire. Fire, yeah. Every part of me wanted to get out of the trenches, but I could hear Italian yelling. I knew my friends were trapped. Everywhere I looked, too late. I felt alone among ghosts. After a while, I couldn't even look at the bodies. You had to have made it to the fort. Through the underground tunnels, or above ground by circling around the back.
Not through the front?
I no longer had my armor. It was impossible.
Thank you.
No, Matteo wasn't there. I still think about that field. Every day. I'd almost stopped looking. Started giving in to the hope that Matteo had escaped. And then...
No! No!
He never got older. And here I am, still. Who decides such things?
In the deserts of Arabia, an insurgency war was raging years before I got to France.
A lone fighter has just one advantage over a large enemy force. A lone fighter can move unseen. Cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war.
Thank you. Ercan, sen onu istersin.
There's a world of difference between sea.
Well, you did not think we would be fast enough to catch you here, did you? Lawrence of Arabia.
I was rather depending on it.
Eh, Lawrence? Well, this is very clever. Now the hunter becomes the hunted. So who might you be? How enchanting you are, my dear.
Ahmed. I'll show you enchanting. If it weren't for you, I'd be free.
Free, is it? You'll be free when you're dead. And I'm happy to tell you, the Empire intends to grant you all this freedom very soon. Even now, an engine of destruction scours this desert, obliterating your allies, your families, your homes. Soon there will be nowhere to run! Nowhere to hide! Soon all that you know, and all that you love, will be ashes. You will all be free. You animal!
Zara!
Oh.
Now, I understand that you would like nothing more than to strip the flesh from that man's feet and send him off into the desert naked to die. But think about it.
You're right.
I'm sorry. My friend here, she can be a little brusque.
You're going to tell me
how to lie to your train, so we can lure it into a trap and destroy it.
Impossible. To even begin to talk to that train, you would need an entire book of communication codes.
Oh, like this one, you mean?
You can never stop the progress of machines! One day, the whole world will take your lands and the precious black gold beneath its sands!
We shall see, my friend.
Of course, obtaining the codebook was not enough. To destroy this Iron Dragon, this Canavar, as the Ottomans had named it, we had to send it 3 encrypted messages telling it to stand down. There were Ottoman outposts scattered along the railroad. We had to use those to send our orders. Infiltrating the village wouldn't be easy. A full detachment of Ottoman soldiers had occupied it. The Ottomans had chosen an isolated location for their desert outpost. It seemed lightly defended. It was also well stocked with arms and equipment. The ancient ruins were all that remained of a civilization now lost to time. The Ottoman Empire brought in the modern world with a host of armored vehicles and field guns. 3 commanders to eliminate, 3 personal message capsules to be stolen, and then sent with our false orders. How Zara tackled this dangerous and audacious mission was up to her. The Bedouin treasured their horses, and in return, those animals granted their riders unparalleled speed and mobility. Here! single order wouldn't be enough. Ottoman protocol required the message to be received in triplicate before the train would acknowledge it as genuine. but complete confidence that she would carry the day.
Oh, you see, the message had already been sent, my dear. Not the message you would have wanted. Elorens was such a good host. It almost seemed rude to escape. I made sure to note the location of Lawrence's camp, of course. Which means the train knows too. Twice, you told that train everything was clear. But I told it exactly where to attack.
The beast has your scent, my dear. And it's coming to slaughter you and your little band of rebels. The legend of Lawrence of Arabia dies tonight.
He slipped away just in time. Tilkichi was a fool to think we'd ever stay after he escaped.
The Carnivore won't stop hunting us.
No, it won't. Let me think.
The train's coming a long way, so it'll have to stop to take on water. That's where we strike.
Agreed. I'll deal with any sentries, then rig explosives on the track.
Yes, and I'll rally our fighters.
When I blow the lines, the train will be trapped. So when you hear the blast, you need to attack them with everything you have.
It's good. But you know that there's a chance the men may not come. You may set off those explosives and find you're out there all alone. You know that.
I guess I won't know either way until I set it off.
Yes, no.
Man makes plans, and God laughs. As it turned out, the small town where we would ambush the train had a significant enemy presence. Those troops would have to be dealt with before the explosives could be set. Man makes plans, and God laughs. As it turned out, the small town where we would ambush the train had a significant enemy presence. Those troops would have to be dealt with before the explosives could be set. man makes plans and God laughs. As it turned out, the small town where we would ambush the train had a significant enemy presence. Those troops would have to be dealt with before the explosives could be set. Man makes plans and God laughs. As it turned out, the small